Sir, in a type 2 grammar, where there is a gamma. So, sir, gamma is belongs to terminal set of to union of terminals and non-terminals.
Yeah, it's a very good question. Ahamika, this is a very good question. That means she wants to learn these things. Yes. Every string ultimately is consist of terminals. No variable should be there. Now the thing is that string, whether it is accepted by a machine or not. Okay. When we have a grammar, the left hand side S and right hand side any number of terminals and a only one more variable, that is called right linear grammar. With this grammar, if we generate a string, then we call a regular grammar. Now, this is a type 3 grammar. But if you follow this, then if you have a language, like if you have a string of, like if your alphabet AB and your string is coming A to the power n, B to the power n. What is A to the power n and B to the power n? Say 10 number of A's and 10 number of B's, or 12 number of A's, 12 number of B's. That is a language. This is the language that, what is a language? Language we say A to the power n, B to the power n. This language can never be generated from the production rules, whatever I have mentioned right now. So we need a different production rules, and that so then that can be done by a push-down automata, and that is a type 2 grammar. So coming back to Ahomika's question, so for type 3 grammar, for type 2 grammar, that is called context-free grammar, then context-sensitive grammar, where left-hand side can be any variable, any string, right-hand side any string, then the type 0, more powerful. Everywhere there should be some rules. From the rules we can generate the sentences, and sentences consist of terminals. Okay, but how the terminals are generated, what is the pattern of the terminals, then it determine whether it is a regular grammar, whether it is a context-free grammar, whether it is a context-sensitive grammar, like A to the power n, B to the power n, C to the power n language, it is a context-sensitive grammar. Okay, so I'll come details. Ahomika, just any question, or anybody can ask any question on this. Let me first, Ahomika, question please.
Sir, finite, there is two types of finite automata, finite automata with loop and without loop. Sir, can you please explain these
Yeah,
matters?
that I am great thing. That I've also number of times said. Finite automata without loop means you have a language that is finite, and whenever you have a loop, that means you have an infinite language. So that is interesting. So finite automata, like a switch, a finite automata with no loop. So that is a fi the language is either 0 and 1 accepted. So that is a done by a combinatorial circuit. What is combinatorial circuit? You know, different all types of NAND gates, you give some signals, either yes or no, it is coming. That is a combinatorial circuit. But within a combinatorial circuit, if you have a feedback, some, you can have a flip-flop, JK flip-flop, D-type flip-flop. Whenever you have a this flip-flop, then you have a sequential circuit. Sequential circuit, you know, is more powerful. It remembers its state. That is a finite state machine. But it cannot remember whatever the state I'm coming from. So it is presently remember this current state. Okay, so that is a finite state machine. It can produce infinite language. So you are correct. Regular language are two type. One is from finite machine and finite language. So that is a combinatorial circuit without any feedback path. So only fixed strings are allowed. Say 110 is allowed, 111 allowed. So that is then the language is 110 and 111. So if you give the language 000, it will not give output. So that is not accepted. So that is a finite language. So that is basically we are not discussing finite language. We are going for infinite language. Infinite language, there should be some feedback path. Omega clear? Or I'll come again. Yeah. Any question, Omega?
No, sir. For now,
No. If you have a question, you can carry on. Carry on questions. Anyone other technical question? Just open for technical. Anyone, please? Anyone? Yeah.
sir,
Yeah.
actually,
there was an example, it was based on conversion of NDFA to DFA.
Yes.
So, sir, can you please explain me that? Actually, I wasn't able to understand that. So, should I forward that?
No, I already covered in my previous classes. I'll again cover in my next classes. Basic thing is non-deterministic finite automata. It whenever from one state it goes to any number of state. Say you have a state A, it go to state B and C with one. So with one I can go B and C. Then in DFA the state will be all states should be a different state. If the state is here from A. And if we titillate it with 1, it go to B and with 1 go to C. So, in DFA, it will be a set of A and it can go to, because B and C, a set of BC. So, it is a combined set. So, DFA is a power set. Okay. So, it can go to, with 1, it can go B or it can go also C. So, whenever we make a DFA, my will be 1, not B, not C, it's a combination set of B, C together. So, B, C together is a set. So, all the sets in a non-deterministic finite automata will be totally changed. Now, whenever we make a deterministic, whenever you see from one transition, I can go B, C, D. Then my DFA, it will be with 1. I have a within second bracket open B, C, D, second bracket end. This is a new set, then B or C are together. Okay, so I will design, so that's it. I think some of you have understood. Please read the books, my notes, I have already sent a note. This NDFA to DFA, this is the way you have to make it. So, any more question? Any more technical questions? But this is the online.
Sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, can you explain the DFA with one example?
Yeah, definitely. I'll cover it. Because you DFA with example means it is a fixed. It will go to only one state. Okay. I have already covered. You see my videos. I'll remember. I'll try to cover again. Besides, DFA I covered fully because I will again cover. Any more other questions? I remember your all questions. I'll try to touch it in my next videos. Any more questions? Okay, great. So then I am presenting today's class. If we can have certain things we can touch. Yeah, this is a DFA example. Say DFA, say there should be an initial state, only one initial state, and there may be one or more final state or accepting state. There might be no accepting state, then there will be nothing will be accepted, your language will be shy. Shy means no language is accepted. Here, fortunately, this is accepting. What does it do? So, if you say DFA, 0 with comebacks here, it 1, 1, 1. After these 3 ones, anything happens, it goes to this state. So, this is the DFA which accepts any language, 3 ones coming together. Okay. So, this is the, what is the language? W contains, the W is string here, 3 ones as a substring. So, this is a typical hardware. You do not need any push down automata stack. To count it, probably you might think I can count and say 3-1. No, I am not counting. I am just state transition. After 3-1s, I got it. So, this is one example of DFA. So, this is the formal definition of DFA. Q is a number of states that I already covered. And this is a Q is a finite number of states. And this is the input alphabet. So, it's a Cartesian product. And it must go to the Q. So, this is a DFA, but if it is a non-deterministic DFA, it should be power set, 2 to the power Q. It can go anywhere. So, but DFA, it could go to the mapping for this is called a delta function, mapping function. It is go to the same state, and q0 is the initial state, and f is one or more state which are accepting state or final state. All this documentation has taken from MIT document. Document is also available. I am quoted it. Yeah, this is Michael Sifsa's definition, same thing that I covered in my earlier videos. Covered. This is any DFA, you can have a diagram, or you can have a, this is the delta transition function in a tabular format. That will also do. This is the states, but here you have to mention which is the starting state here, say A, and this is the input symbol and which state it goes to. This is a, you can put your delta transition function in a diagram. Diagrams is more visible, or you can do it here also, like this. And your accepting state, final state is here, like it is shown it here. Yes, this I have covered. This is subsequent, this is called delta hat or delta star. So, it has to be serially converted. This is, I have already covered in one of the classes. I just see anything I keep with more example. This is a finite automata, 101 as a substring. Say if 101, it will accept. So this is a DFA. If 101 is a substring, it will always accept. How to say it is a DFA? Say with 0 only 1, it is no other state. If with 0 I can come here, with here, then it is a non-NDFA, which is difficult to design. Contains either 0, 0 and 1 as a substring. So, this is a DFA and this is a trap state. So, if it comes there, it will not accept. So, these are two only the accepting state. This I have covered. Let us see any NDFA. Yeah, this is a DFA which accepts epsilon, because without anything it accepts, and any number of zeros it accepts. But if say 1, no, it will not accept, because if I have not mentioned 1 anywhere, so it accepts only zeros, only 1 0, no 0, any number of zeros. This diagram will say it accepts 0, any number of 0 and single 1. If it is a more 1, it will not accept, because if it is a more 1, nothing is specified here. So any number of zeros ended with 1, this hardware and accept any number of zeros, it can accept, or any number of zeros with only single one. If any other zero comes, it will not accept. If any other ones, it will not accept. This is a simple hardware which can accept. This is a language. This language is, say, it can accept epsilon, because at the initial state, it will accept its state, and like this, it can accept. Yeah.
Sir, is it possible to define it loop element?
Yeah, it is a loop element. This is a loop. This is a loop. See, it is as per your specification or regular expression, you have to design your finite state machine. You have to remember the this trick, how to, this is a loop also. So, how to accept a language which accepts single zero or any number of zero or any number of zero with one. Even a single one, it will not accept it, because even a single one, it is accepted. Yes, because it comes here, single one accepted. But if it more number of ones, it will not accept. So, it this language accepts blanks epsilon, because why is epsilon? Because initial state is a accepting state, then it can accept single zero, yes, multiple number of zeros, yes, then single one, from here to one, any more one, no, it will not accept, only single one. So, this is a interesting, so if you practice this small thing, I will try to make more some small examples I'll see fine. Any more any doubt here, please? Thank you. So here, try to get, this is a loop element. You ask this. All non-empty blocks is one. This is, say, any that I have covered, and this is a loop is there. C is not a trap state. So 0 can be returned and 1 should not be returned. The string ends with 2 ones. Let's see the next example. All non-empty blocks of 1 have odd length. All non-empty blocks of 1s in W have odd length. See here, you can see the 1, 1 and another one. So odd length. Here you see the loop. Somebody asks the loop, you see the loop is here. So you might argue this is the only diagram. No. You can have more number of states to same language, but if you minimize the number of states, the diagram should be unique. So you, from a regular expression or a description of your language, whenever you are design a finite state machine, the finite state machine can number of more number of states, but if you minimize it, then ultimately the diagram should be same for all. That is a 1:1 correspondence. We'll give some examples. See, say another DFA example. Here the DFA language, that is set of all strings of zeros and ones whose numbers are both even. Both even, this is the accepted state. See, either 1, 1, this is the accepted state, 0, 0, accepted state. This I took from Michael Sifson's book. In the, has 3 states. In the beginning we described, this is the accepted state. You take any number of zeros, only 1 accepted, any number of 1 accepted. If it goes to 0 and come back with either 0 or 1, both. So you can have this kind of arc is also there. It is better if you have a 2 different arcs, but sometimes you see this common arc, C, 0, 1, but it is a FSM. It is a FSM. This is a definition of this Michael Sifson I have covered. This is I have covered, nothing much. This is regular language, more subset is combinatorial circuit, that is finite language. This is regular language. Regular language I have mentioned number of times. This is the area context fit. These are the areas is a to the power n, b to the power n, unit stack. Will come later after 2-3 classes. But I will give in the, what are the limitation of regular language. Regular language cannot accept a to the power n, b to the power n. And if it cannot accept a to the power n, b to the power n, it cannot accept any function call. Because whenever in program you call a function, you call repeatedly. Whenever a function, there is some opening brace, closing brace. So you have to remember how many times I have opening braces, how many times I have closing braces. So without procedural function, any programming language cannot be done. So that is the reason your regular language is unfit for a full-fledged programming language. But with a regular expression, you can create your variable type. So that is great. So regular language is finite state machine. All our day-to-day mechanical devices, whatever C is, are all finite state machine. But whenever you go programming, the programming means you need one function you call repeated times, then you need a more powerful grammar, that is called deterministic context free grammar, and non-deterministic context free is there, that is a more powerful. Both this case you need a deterministic PDA, that means finite state machine along with the stack. See here these things I have again and again. This is regular language, regular expression, regular set I have covered in my last video. Regular set is you can see union, intersection, and expression. Instead of union, you can see plus sign. All are same. That is the high, and all these are all type 3 language. This I have covered in my earlier classes. This is right linear. See here, x is any string of terminals. Your variable at the end, only one variable, that is right linear. But if you have a production rule, then one is such rule and one is that rule, then it is not a regular grammar. Then it will be context free grammar. So only then it will be context free grammar. If you will be given the rules and you see one variable at the end and another is variable at the front, then it is not a regular grammar. This is a context free grammar. In context free grammar also, left hand side a variable only, like regular grammar. But regular grammar, variable can be at the end or at the beginning, not both. And in context free grammar, any strings of terminals, any number of strings and variable on the right hand side, that is great. And from there you can generate the language, a to the power n, b to the power n language. This I have covered. Regular expression I have told again and again. The expression, this is a regular set. This is a set description, this is the expression. So both you have to know. This is the expression and this is regular set. I prefer regular set, this notation, and this is regular expression. You use this regular expression whenever you want to find some C file, lsstart.c. like this. So that is the same concept. Star is here. Star means zero or any occurrence. This is I explain. I regular expression is this, regular language is this. I now I can take more questions. I remember some of you have your doubts. I tried to have more examples ready, and I've already tried, but any more question you please. These things, any doubt of anything, you must have doubts, because if you have doubts, that means you are learning. If you don't have doubts, then you are not learning. So, but please express your doubts. Anyone?
Sir.
Yeah.
So, if there is an example and it is a regular language, and you say that. What should I say, that we mention or term it any term an example as context free language, so it should be described as type 2.
No, regular language is different sets of language, and context free language is a type 2 language. You just try to hammer in your brain. Regular language is a type 3. Yeah.
Yes.
What is your question? That if it is a non-regular language, which is not regular language, that it can be type 2, it can be type 1, it can be type 0. So if a language is not regular, that doesn't mean it is a type 2. It can be type 2, it can be type 1, which is more powerful, that is a context sensitive grammar, like a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n. That is a context sensitive grammar, that is a type 1, then the type 0 grammar. Examples of type 0 grammar is whatever the mathematical formula, what is the algorithm you can put, that is all type 0 grammar. So if you have an integer number like say a to the power n b, what kind of grammar it is? It is a regular grammar. A to the power n b to the power p, what kind of language? Regular grammar. Because no relation between a to the power n and p. But if we say a to the power n b to the power p, p must be greater than n, then it is not regular. It is a context free grammar, because I am comparing between a to the power n and b to the power p. I am comparing p and n. Then I need a stack for comparing. So then it is a type 2 grammar. So again I am repeat, say a to the power m, b to the power n, it is a regular grammar. How? With a, you put any number of counter, it is a to the power, catch a to the power m and b to the power n, no relation, regular grammar. A to the power m, b to the power n, m equal to n, or then it must be type 2 grammar. Okay. Or if you say a to the power 2.2m, b to the a to the power p, p is a prime number, then it is a type 0 grammar. A to the power p, p is a prime number, then it is a type 0 grammar. Okay. It is very tough, but it can be done by Turing machine only. Not finite state machine cannot accept a to the power p grammar. But these things I will come detail. But for regular grammar, it can solve many a problem. Many problem. That is, say our college, that is a finite state machine. It can solve. But it cannot remember what are the I have done in last week. Okay. So, but in a current traversal, it can remember what are the floats here it is coming down and what are the floats leaving. Please ask question. Ask any damn question, that is great. Good, you are asking this question. Plus, before asking the question, because I am in all presentation mode, I cannot see your face. Please, you tell your name, ask any question on this. Then, our later on, we can again have certain time period for our project and this mini presentation, quiz and all these things. But later, any technical question, good questions asked. I like it. Please ask question. Ask any question. This is a very, very interesting diagram, I must say. So, this is the, it is a Sifsa's book. See, this defines deterministic computation and non-deterministic computation. Non-deterministic computation, if it can take any path, if it found one and only accept, then it accept. It can find two accept, it accept. But if that doesn't get any accept state, it reject it. So, this, but to design this hardware is impossible. So, ultimately, we have to convert non-deterministic finite automata to deterministic finite automata. So, it can take more number of states, but it can be easily designed. Okay. Any question, please? Any question, anyone? Please. Ask. Those who have asked the question can question ask repeatedly. I want new one. Orko is there? Orko Prabhu, Disha, Devanjana, Aditi, any question please? Question, non-deterministic FA, non-deterministic DFA. Yeah, this is it. I'll make a, this is a non-deterministic. Why? I can give away, we jump from this state or this state. This is epsilon. This you cannot find it in a deterministic automata. In deterministic automata, you cannot find epsilon transition. In deterministic automata, you cannot find with A, it can go only one and only state. But this is a non-deterministic finite automata. But it appears powerful, but it can be proven both are same. This I have explained. This is because it's epsilon transition with A, we can go different state. So it has to be converted, but these states would be different. This Q and this Q are different. Yeah, that is this thing we try to end today's class. What is the closure property? Closure property means any regular language, two regular language, if you make union, that is also regular language. And then what is interesting is homomorphism. What is homomorphism? It is excellent idea. Homomorphism means you change the symbol 1 is to 1 by only different symbol. Say it is AB, you give alpha beta. So any language, not only regular language, then it is the context-free language, context-sensitive language, are all closed under, closed means homomorphism. Homomorphism means if you replace the symbol, it is this. But regular language, one great thing is it is union, you know, intersection, complement, but complement of context-free grammar is not a context-free grammar. That is, complement of difference context-free grammar is not. That we have to study. But here, regular language, if you put any regular language, if you put these operations, union, reversal means you set the string in reverse, from left to right or right to left. So, this is also regular. Clean closure means if you clean closure will give repeated application, concatenation, one regular language, concatenate by other regular language. This is a regular language. So, regular language, union, intersection, complement, you see the complement and difference, it will be not there in context-free language. Difficult to prove, but you have to remember right now. See here, closure properties of context-free language. Why you are very much interested in context-free language? Because most of our 99% of our programming language depends on context-free language. Otherwise, you do not have context-free language, you cannot write a to the power n, b to the power n, you cannot write if-then-else structure, you cannot have opening brace, closing brace, these braces should be matched. So, context-free language is a must. The context-free language, union, concatenation, clean, closure are close, but not under operation, intersection and complement. It can be a regular language also, it can be a context-free language also. So, it is two context-free language with intersection, it is unknown. Complementation unknown. So, these things you have to put your mind. You try to give examples. Closer to regular language are closer like this. If you have a this string and this string, and if you make a two string together, then it is a Cartesian product. You see the Cartesian product of this, and this is also a regular, this is also a finite state machine, and this is also a regular language. We will give details. So, if you have a machine, this machine we have a just Cartesian product, and your final state will be this, and either or F1 or F2. It may be F1 or F2. Closure under union, this I have covered. If you have to open up some books, closure under union, so two finite state machine. If we, yeah, any question? Please make your microphone off.
Yes. Yes, sir. You can see your name.
What's your name? What's your name, please?
Sir, Ritika.
Ritika.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Ritika, question, please.
Sir, Mealy machine and Moore machine.
Mealy machine and Moore machine, I will cover. Mealy machine and Moore machine, good question. Mealy machine and Moore machine are all finite state machine. Mealy machine give output with every transition. Okay, and Moore machine give output only at the state. So, whatever we are giving, whatever machine I have covered are Moore machine. Mealy machine means whenever you give a symbol, it transfer to one state, it gives the output also. So, like this, if you give, like here, if you epsilon transition, we give an output. That is Mealy machine. Mealy machine gives output at every transition, it doesn't depend on state, and Moore machine gives output after reaching state, that is Moore machine. So, Moore machine is more stable, Mealy machine might do different behavior and glitches. So, Moore machine will be more focused on Moore machine. Good question asked, I will try to make video on Moore and Mealy very soon. But good question. Any other question? Have you understood Moore and Mealy? Both are finite state machine. Moore machine only give output at the state. After reaching the state, you will get the output. Whether any output, 0, 1, 2, like this. There is some output associated with this state. Say, here, whenever you have a concentric circle, we have a accept. If it is not concentric circle, reject. So, that is an output. That is a decision problem, because whenever we have a calculator at your childhood class, you can calculate root 2, root 4. These are all numerical problems, but now whenever you are more sophisticated, you are just interested whether it is accepted or not. This is called decision problems. Now, decision problems are more harder. Though it seems numerical problems is tougher, but it is easy. It can be done by a calculator, by combinatorial circuit. But whenever we have a decision problem, we have to need a programming language, whether it accepts or rejects, whether it accepts or rejects. This is a tougher problem. Okay, and this accept means whenever it reaches the accepting state. That is a Moore machine. And the Mealy machine is, it gives output. That it is not accept or reject, it gives some output. Okay, but whether it is accept or reject, same as a moon machine. So Mealy machine gives some extra output after transition. That's it. Okay, so if you see the counter is a moon machine. Okay, the counter is a moon machine, which can detect ages. That is a Mealy machine and give output. That is a, but whenever you are putting your card in a ATM machine, that is a Moore machine. So you put your card, it sends some glitches, then it go to another state, try to give your password. So that is a Moore machine. Okay. So if you give a password which is not accepted, it rejects. A Moore machine. Okay. Good question. Any questions? Ritika, clear?
Yes, sir. No more questions.
I'll try to. It's a good question. Moore and Mealy, I am not covered, but good, you have us covered. Let's see. I have some presentation there. Please don't make a
mistake. Sir, I just asked because you said about the closure. That's why I asked
yes.
about that.
Closure. Yeah, closure. This closure means not clean closure. There's some confusion. This closure means whether you put two regular language. You put two regular language together, whether that language, that is a regular language. But if we have one regular language, you subtract one regular language, that is also regular language, closure. But if we have a to the power n, b to the power n language, what is that? That is context-free grammar language, and you negate a context-free language, CFG. But that is may not be context-free, that may not be regular. So that is, closure operation is not there for context-free grammar. So, but regular language, all are closer. Okay, so that's it. Good question you have asked. I have some Mead and Moore, just a thing. I have some, just a minute. Whatever the slides I have given it, it is there. Okay, I think today, this thing I must say here. This is a finite state machine and regular are all same. This is a combinatorial circuit. That is a, it is not infinite language. It is a finite language. And it can be done by combinatorial circuit. Somebody has asked the question in the beginning. And this is finite state machine. Though finite state machine, it can have an infinite language. But infinite language is very useful. Like all our mechanical devices, whatever you see is a finite state machine. And example is our lift, and push down automata is the next interesting thing, that it is vital for our programming languages. So the context free push down, so this is a machine and this is a language. Now what is machine? You need to compute, and how to program the machine, you need a language. So they are together. So all this relationship, it is now it is understood, but it is done by several scientists. Language part is done single-handedly by Noam Chomsky, is still living, and this part several scientists is there, from Alan Turing and lots of scientists are there. So it is not a single man's dream. Okay, so I have covered, because the automata, you know what is not only complexity, from your data structure class you know complexity, but now in automata class you know what are uncomputable. So, like halting problem I told beginning, these are halting problem means you cannot design a program which can take any program and tell that program you stop or not. Okay, there's a halting problem. There's an undecidable problem. No algorithm for this. If no algorithm, you cannot program it. Okay. Thank you for attending the class.